Well, in 2005, an Israeli archaeologist announced to the world that she had uncovered the ruins of King David's palace in Jerusalem.
Since then, Ilat Mazar has excavated various sites in Jerusalem. And as Gordon Robertson tells us, she's relied on the Bible to understand those discoveries.
Three thousand years ago, the entire city of Jerusalem fit on this 12-acre hill. Here you can see part of the wall rebuilt by Nehemiah, the water tunnel dug by King Hezekiah, and the Pool of Siloam, where Jesus healed a blind man. This is the city of David.
Welcome to the City of David. Good morning, my name is Miriam.
Today, it's one of Jerusalem's top tourist sites, with close to 500,000 visitors every year.
This is one of the most exciting places on earth. People from all over the world come to this place and for the first time understand that what they're reading in the text matches the archaeology in the ground.
The City of David is more than just a tourist attraction. It's also a live archaeological dig. The Bible says this is where King David built his palace, and one archaeologist says she's found it. For Ilat Mazar, digging is a family affair. In 1948, her grandfather, Benjamin Mazar, was the first archaeologist to get a digging permit in the new state of Israel. And when the Israelis recaptured Jerusalem in 1967, he started excavating the area around the Temple Mount. His granddaughter, Ilat, was working by his side when she was just 11 years old.
What I've learned from him, the major thing is that the Bible is part of our historical sources to be used and restudied and reexamined again and again. It doesn't object in any way to our scientific archaeological capability of using the best methods for excavations. It goes side by side and it fits beautifully, and it should.
Like her grandfather, Mazar is uncovering the Jerusalem of the Bible, layer by layer. In 2005, she started digging in the City of David with one goal in mind.
King David's palace. Well, I had my assumptions based on the evidence at that time. And then when I started the excavations, it was, of course, an open question.
It wasn't long before she found what she was looking for.
We saw the large walls of some structure, but they were so large that I said, wow, okay, forget about King David's palace. We're talking about a fortress here. We realized that this structure, as monumental and impressive as it is the first structure ever built in that spot. So the question, who built this structure and what was this structure built for?
Mazar soon found her answer.
We've got a marvelous, marvelous historical source, which is called the Bible. The core of historical events surely are there.